But we're going to begin this hour with stand-up superstar, that's Sebastian Maniscalco, and screen legend, that would be the one and only Robert De Niro. Thank you very much. The two entertainers first joined forces on the film The Irishman back in 2019, and now they're on the screen together again, this time in a new comedy. It's called About My Father. Now, this movie is loosely based on Maniscalco's relationship with his dad, Salvatore, known as Salvo, a hairstylist in the Chicago area where Maniscalco grew up. So we caught up with Robert De Niro, Maniscalco, and his dad, a Chicago salon, GC by George Charles. Thank you, George Charles, for letting us take over your salon for a bit to talk about the movie. But first, we stopped by a nearby sandwich shop for a very special surprise.
Comedian Sebastian Maniscalco has sold out arenas across the country.
Dad was working 18 hours a day. I think I formally met my dad when I was 18 years old.
His dad, Salvatore Maniscalco, is a common theme in his acts. So we decided to meet up with him at this Chicago suburb deli in his neighborhood. They have a very special sandwich there.
We heard this is where you can get a good Sebastian Maniscalco sandwich.
You definitely heard correct.
Hi,
yes.
You guys.
How are you?
What do you think, Salvo, when you come in and there's a sandwich named after your son?
I can't believe it, really. I can't.
Really?
It's great.
What is it about him that you think is so good?
I mean, that him growing up and hearing the stories of his childhood, I mean, I have the exact same stories. The eggplant sandwiches at lunch and kids would laugh at me. Like, I have that.
The school wasn't responsible if the veal piccata spoiled.
I know, he's so good, though.
I hear you got some amazing sandwiches.
Yes,
what's going on? How's
nice
it going?
To meet you.
What's happening?
Hi, oh, I'm so glad to see you.
I gotta ask you, what's the revenue on the sandwich a month?
Oh, here we go. All right, three Sebastian specials.
Nice.
Three Sebastian specials, okay. That tomato, fresh.
Excellent on the sandwich, I gotta tell you.
Beautiful, love to hear that.
Salvo, was he a funny little kid?
He was always, because he loved stage.
Yeah.
I mean, when I see him there, and performing, I can read his mind and say, yes, that's where I belong.
But now, you know, he's funny, but you're such a big part of his act. Were you always comfortable with it?
Always comfortable.
You were?
Yes.
You
because?
Never... Why? Because of the money.
You can say anything about me.
Tell us, Salvo, the relationship between the two of you, what it means to you.
Family is a major thing for me. I mean, as a father, it's life.
And Sebastian is highlighting their father-son bond in his new movie. It's called About My Father.
50 years ago, I come to this country to give you a better life.
Was it a hard story to tell for you?
Not necessarily hard. It was hard to perform, to act, because I don't generally do that. Now I'm doing it with one of the greatest actors who ever lived.
Enter Robert De Niro.
Never rat on your friends. And always keep your mouth shut.
The Academy Award-winning actor plays Sebastian's father.
Dial it down.
The real Salvo has been a hairstylist since the 60s, so we sat down with his trio at a hair salon.
I was curious about you, Bob De Niro, now that you played him. Like, if I wanted you to wash my hair, color my hair, braid my hair, could we go in the back and you could do that?
No, I'd have to bring Salvo with me.
I was checking out your highlights on TV.
So how did this come about, Sebastian? Did you say, Dad, I sure would like it if Robert De Niro played me in a movie?
It was unreal that the man said yes, because you just don't think that Robert De Niro is going to end up playing your father. It's something that is, you know, it was like a dream come true. You know, I called him. He don't believe nothing, right? I'm like, De Niro's going to play you. He's like, yeah, right, come on. I don't believe it until I see it. Go ahead.
I said, wait a minute, did I hear right? So I said, let me get my hearing aid, because I said, it's impossible. I said, no way.
I don't even know if you know what was going on our side. You're just doing movies and we're sitting over here going, this is the guy I had on my wall as a kid. So it was super exciting.
And I wonder what it's like for you when you hear people, what you just said, Sebastian, I had posters of, you know, movies of yours. Mm-hmm. On his wall. What is it like for you to hear what you mean to so many people?
I'm honored and flattered. Yes. At the same time, I cringe a little bit.
Why?
Because it makes me uncomfortable. But I'm not complaining.
But do you know you're that good though? Do you know? Do you? You gotta know it, no? I mean, like, when you watch yourself in a movie, do you go, "Oh my God, I'm unbelievable"?
No.
I know. I often wonder that. Do you look at yourself? Are you a hard critic of yourself when you watch yourself on screen?
Yeah, I mean, I look at myself at certain things. I say, "Oh God, I can't look at that." Part of it is for vanity, but excluding the vanity part, what it is that you're doing character-wise, what you're supposed to do, what the task is at hand.
But there is a key scene in the end when it's a very emotional scene between the two of you. Was that difficult for you, Sebastian, that scene?
Yeah, that was the scene that I was kind of pining over the whole time I was on set. Like, I'm gonna have to get emotional, I'm gonna have to cry, something I've never done on film. I go to him, I said, "Listen, I need help here. I don't know what I'm doing. Could you help me out?" And he goes, "Well, you know, I didn't want to say anything. I don't know what your process is." And I'm like, "My process is just hope. Hope this happens."
But before you finish, you have a process when it's time for you to cry? I think that's
interesting. The one thing is not to force anything or try and get it or push for it. Either you have it or you don't. The worst thing you could do is push something that's not there. Better that you don't do anything. And that to me is the most important. Like, sometimes you can't, you know? It's like doing a play every night, a certain performance. Some days you can have it, or nights, and others you just don't, and you just, but you're a professional, you go through it, you do it.
What did he say to you?
No, he did. He said, "Think about your father. When you do this, think about your father." And then in the conversation, it got emotional between him and I. And I started crying in the conversation. I go, I gotta use this. So I'm running, crying, thinking about my dad. I come into the scene crying, right? I do the scene, right? And they yell, "Cut." "All right, again?" I'm like, "Again?" That's all I got. So it just taught me a lot about getting to certain places while you're acting.
Yeah. But, you know, at the crux of the movie, it's a love story between families. Mm-hmm. And I ultimately think those of us with adult children, we want our children to be proud of us, and on the reverse, we want to be proud of them. Don't you think?
Yeah, ultimately, that's the goal. I mean, now yes. that I have a son, you know, I want him to look up to me like I look up to my dad.
Yes.
So now that we're here in Chicago, when I left in 1998, 2023, sitting in the salon with my dad, and it's a big moment for me. And
yes.
I want to thank you for being, playing my father, and I want to thank you for being the best father I could ask for. And sometimes I don't reflect on things that happen in my career, and it's happening right now on your show. So
I think about this little boy that had Robert De Niro as a poster in his wall. I do think that that's big.
That's big.
Sal, did Robert De Niro capture your essence?
Well, yeah, he did a fantastic job, I think.
Okay.
See, I'm crying too now. See?
I know that emotion at the end. I think it took everybody by surprise, including Sebastian, said, "You know, Gayle, you don't have to use that part." I go, "Oh, no, that's it. That's going to be in slow-mo."
Yeah, right.
But I have to say a special thank you to Forza Meats that has that Sebastian sandwich on the menu. The ingredients: prosciutto, burrata, mozzarella, arugula, tomato, pesto, balsamic, hot giadanero.
Italian vegetable, like,
okay.
A little
what is it?
Vegetable
Italian
mix,
man?
Like, it's like
hot giardiniera,
peppers and onion. Yeah.
On French bread. Mario and Tyler, we thank you. And special thanks to the trio. I'm going to do something and talk the table, because they were all so touching to me. You see, Robert De Niro really doesn't like compliments.
No, but I love that
you
put his
hand like, no,
on Sebastian.
I know.
But that's like a De Niro moment where, you know, one of the greatest actors of his generation looks over and sees somebody getting emotional.
Yeah.
You get
a
pat on the back from Robert De Niro.
No, it was very, very, very tender moment.
Meanwhile,
and the movie, by the way, is really, really, really good.
It looks terrific, yeah.
It's very, great. Very funny.
I love that they're all in little salon chairs, though, with their feet up, their knees a little high. You'd almost imagine, like, the big hair dryer over their heads.
Yes.
It was great.
I do love the fact that, you know, that at the end of the day, what you said, Gayle, which is that he had this man's picture on his wall.
I know.
And now he's playing.
And now that man's picture on the wall knows your name and your number.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Very cool.